We are very proud to introduce the first router powered by our Express5 chipset. Imagine 28.8 terabits per second of forwarding capacity on a single chiplet-based package. That's 36 ports, 800 gigi, 72 times 400 gigi without breakout cable, or even 288 interfaces, 100 gigi, on a single 2RU router. But it's not only fast and power optimized. You will be surprised by the scale and the features. The PTX10002 36QDD is a compact form factor router, 2RU, offering 28.8T of connectivity and forwarding capability. It's the first router in our portfolio powered by the new Express5 packet forwarding engine. The Juniper Express silicon line has been introduced in 2011. At that time, the goal was to transform the economics of packet transport networks by optimizing the forwarding path for density and interface speed. Initially, it was designed for core use case like MPLS LSR, labeled switch router, with relatively low scale routing. Over five generations, the Express chipset evolved and expanded their capabilities both in terms of supported scale and functionalities. In this illustration, we can see the Express5 supports high scale and complex forwarding protocols, but also advanced services like in-band network telemetry and HQoS. Express5 is not a single chip, it's an ASIC family. And it's the first in the networking industry to propose a design based on chiplets. To keep it simple, we can say we have two building blocks and we can mix and match them to create different packages based on the requirement. The X chiplet offers 14.4T of one SerDes on the north side. This SerDes supports bandwidth from 10 to 106 gigabits per second. On the south part, we have very short reach links, XSR SerDes. They can be used to interconnect another X chiplet or an F chiplet inside the same package. The F chiplet is dedicated to fabric connectivity. On the south side of this diagram, we have interfaces where cells will be received and transmitted to the fabric. And the north side is used to potentially interconnect to another X chiplet or F chiplet, again, in the same package. These building bricks can be combined to meet our design needs. We can create packages made of two X chiplets back-to-back, interconnected via the XSR SerDes. It's typically what we will use in the PTX10002 36QDD router. It's gonna be a 28.8T ASIC and we name it BXX. Or it could be one X chiplet paired with one F chiplet, offering one connectivity on one side and fabric connectivity on the other. We will find them in the modular system line cards and we call them BXF. Or finally, it can be one F chiplet offering fabric interfaces. You will find this configuration in modular chassis fabric cards and we call them BF. The PTX10002 36QDD is a standalone platform with no fabric connectivity requirement. And so it is based on a single BXX package made of two X chiplets offering 288 one SerDes at 100 gig, that's 36 ports at 800 gigabits per second or 72 ports at 400 gig. With this package configuration, we don't waste resources for unused fabric. It's ideal for a SIP, a system in the package, where all interfaces are directly connected to the forwarding ASIC. Since Express5 supports MACsec internally, we won't need any additional part to deliver MACsec encryption at line rate on all ports. This chart is listing a couple of key numbers related to this forwarding ASIC. It uses 32 gigabytes of HBM as an external buffer, and we support tons of counters, 8 million, and tons of routes. Today, we only test up to 8 million, but we can double this number if needed one day. And we are not even considering the FIP compression effect, which is enabled by default on all PTX routers since Express4. Even if we are considering a single package here, the chipset is seen by the operating system as two PFE instances that are actually the chiplet dies. And inside each instance, we have two data paths. They are the PFEs from the router perspective and they represent 7.2T of bandwidth. It goes without saying that any bandwidth number expressed here is full duplex. A 7.2T data path can receive and transmit 7.2 terabits per second simultaneously. In the PTX10002 36QDD, each data path will be mapped to 9 physical ports. But let's have a closer look at the router now. The name PTX10002 36QDD is very much self-explanatory. PTX10K generation, 2 rack unit, 36 ports QSFP-DD 800. The usual CLI, show chassis hardware detail, gives you a good overview of the internal parts, chassis, power supply modules, boards, routing engine, we have just one, control board, LED board, optics, fan trays, etc. The only field replaceable parts are the PSMs and the fans. The PTX10236QDD offers power supply 1+1 redundancy and front-to-back fan trays AFO with 2+1 redundancy. The power supply modules, PSM, they exist in AC and DC, but also in two flavors, 3000 watts and 2200 watts. Depending on the type of PSM inserted, the system will operate in a different mode. But we'll come back on this aspect in a few minutes. When we abstract the router to a block diagram, you notice it's a very simple design, and that's what makes it extremely competitive from a power usage perspective. For example, we don't rely on any intermediate component, such as a reverse gearbox, to connect the optical cages to the packet forwarding engine port groups. The 36 ports of the router are split in half, 18 ports mapped to BX0, 18 others to BX1, that's each chiplet. As mentioned earlier, we also have two data paths, or slices if you prefer, of 9 ports each. From a router CLI perspective, these slices are named PFE0 to PFE3. And the port naming logic is also very simple. Since the system is composed of a single FPC and a single PIC, all interfaces are named ET, 0, 0, port, and potential channelization after the colon. Interesting to note that 800 gigabits per second ports will support new types of pluggable and connectors, QDD 2x400G and QDD 8x100G with dual LC duplex and 8x100G interfaces with dual MPO12. In both cases, these are two independent connectors housed inside a single transceiver, and that will simplify the cable management. These connectors enable a high density of 400 gigabit ports without requiring any specific breakout cable or patch panels. With these optics, we support natively 72 ports 400 gigabit. Each physical port is directly mapped to a unique port group, PG, via 8 SerDes. There is no intermediate reverse gearbox or PHY, and therefore we don't have any port combination limitation. You can use all the ports with 2x400 or 8x100 without any constraint. Every port can be configured at the speed you need, but you can only support a unique speed for members of the same physical port channelized. For example, breakout of 4x10 or 8x100. If you have any doubt, don't hesitate to refer to the port checker tool in the Pathfinder webpage. The control plane is handled by a very powerful 10-core Intel CPU running at 3 GHz, and we have plenty of DRAM, 128 GB, for Junos and third-party application running in containers. The PTX10236QDD supports timing features like SyncE and PTP Class C on all ports, and even Class D quality for certain port configuration. We are leveraging the PTP FPGA developed by Juniper, and the preliminary test results are extremely promising. On the back of the chassis, you will find the necessary timing connectivity, TOD, bits, PPS, in and out, etc. One last aspect I would like to detail regarding this new PTX router is the power usage. It was briefly mentioned earlier, but we have two types of power supply modules available. And I don't mean AC or DC, we offer that, of course. I mean the PSMs are available in two flavors, 3000 watts and 2200 watts. By the way, you cannot mix them. Depending on what type of PSM is detected by the system, it will operate in a different manner. When these 2200 PSMs are present, the system will detect them and configure the 400 gig mode. In this operational mode, the Express5 clock is reduced to 65% of its nominal frequency, the ports are limited to 400 gig, and the global forwarding capability is 14.4T. Both 4x112G or 8x56G are supported, but the insertion of any 800G or 2x400G optics is not. It will have an impact on the total power consumption, reducing roughly by 30%. Also, the maximum power per slot will be 25 watts, so we can support 400G ZR. In the second case, 3000 watts PSM are inserted in the back, and the system automatically detects them and configure an 800 gig mode, also named 28.8T mode. Here, Express5 runs at full speed. The ports can be used with 400 gig, 2x400G, 800 gig, etc. And we support up to 30 watts optics in each port. Now, it's possible to configure this chassis in what we call the power optimized mode. even if we have this 3000 watts PSM inserted. Once you commit the config and after a reboot of the system, it's behaving in a similar mode than the 2200 PSMs. Express5 speed is reduced to 65% of its capability, the ports are limited to 400 gig, and the global forwarding becomes 14.4T. And the total consumption is reduced by 30% more or less. So it's an interesting mode of operation if you plan to use native 400 gig ports in the chassis. But we can do more to optimize the power usage. And since the PFE inside this PTX is a BXX design, it's possible to turn off one of the two chiplets. It will reduce the connectivity and the forwarding capability by half to 18 port and 14.4 terabit per second respectively, and it will significantly reduce the energy consumption. This config will save 150 watts as shown in this example here. So the smart approach is to populate first the ports mapped to BX0 in the central part of the chassis, and if you don't need more than 18 ports, and if you are, for example, using pay-as-you-grow, you can shut down half of the package and save quite a lot of electricity. To wrap it up, the PTX 10,236 QDD is a compact and powerful router offering unparalleled 800 gig and 400 gig port density in just two rack unit form factor. Built around a single Express5 silicon chipset with a very simple design, it delivers exceptional energy efficiency, but also a very impressive feature set and scale. I invite you to take a look at our technical blog platform, Juniper Tech Post, for more details. You will find many articles on Express5 and its flexible pipeline or this new PTX router, but also on the new features it supports like flexible offset access list, FIB caching, edge cross, beer, segment routing V6, MACsec on 800 gig ports, inline sampling, telemetry, and many more innovations. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.